Welcome to CamLook, your daily dose of the Cincinnati Art Museum. Each weekday, a staff member or volunteer will be sharing an object from the permanent collection and posing questions for discussion. Be sure to check back each day for a new work and a new chat. My name is Kristen Vincenti, and I am the assistant to the director. As it is June 1st and the start of Pride Month, we wanted to highlight an LGBTQIA artist from our collection. Today, we will be looking at Self Portrait by Robert Mapplethorpe. Pride Month commemorates the ongoing pursuit of equal justice for the lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and queer community, and celebrates the accomplishments of the LGBTQIA individuals. The event that catalyzed the gay rights movement occurred June 28, 1969, at the Stonewall Inn in New York City. Police raided the establishment, which was a popular gathering place for the LGBTQ community. They arrested employees and patrons of the bar while pedestrians watched. Riots ensued in response, lasting about 5 days. At the Eastern Regional Conference of Homophile Organizations in Philadelphia, gay rights activists proposed the idea of a march in response to the Stonewall events. The march occurred on June 28, 1970, the first anniversary of the Stonewall riots, to celebrate gay pride. The event was named the Christopher Street Liberation Day March after the street that was the epicenter of New York City's gay community. The Pride March in New York inspired others to occur across the country in solidarity. Thereafter, gay pride celebrations expanded globally. In the United States, LGBTQIA Pride is a month-long celebration, with marches occurring throughout the month of June. Robert Mapplethorpe was an American photographer concerned with classical aspects of beauty. Whether in his nudes, floral still lifes, or self-portraits, light, shadow, composition, and form were central to all his work. Born on November 4, 1946 in Floral Park, New York, in 1963, Mapplethorpe enrolled at Pratt Institute in nearby Brooklyn, where he studied drawing, painting, and sculpture. Mapplethorpe acquired a Polaroid camera in 1970 and quickly found satisfaction taking Polaroid photographs. Inspired by the mixed media approaches of Joseph Cornell and Marcel Duchamp, Mapplethorpe combined Polaroids with cut text to create collages. Mapplethorpe befriended singer-songwriter and artist Patti Smith while they were both living and working in New York. Smith and Mapplethorpe had a unique relationship. They were friends, lovers, artistic collaborators, and soulmates. In the late 1970s, Mapplethorpe grew increasingly interested in documenting the New York S&M scene. The resulting photographs are shocking for their content and remarkable for their technical and formal mastery. Mapplethorpe told Art News in late 1988, "I don't like that particular word, shocking. I'm looking for the unexpected. I'm looking for things I've never seen before. I was in a position to take those pictures. I felt an obligation to do them." His work came under fire from the religious right in the late 1980s for its supposed obscenity, sparking a national discussion as to whether the U.S. government should fund the arts at all. 1 year before his death, on March 9, 1989, at the age of 42 in Boston, Massachusetts, from an AIDS-related illness, the Whitney Museum of American Art in New York presented the first major retrospective of his work at an American museum. Mapplethorpe's vast, provocative, and powerful body of work has established him as one of the most important artists of the 20th century. Today, Mapplethorpe is represented by galleries in North and South America and Europe, and his work can be found in the collections of major museums around the world. Beyond the art historical and social significance of his work, his legacy lives on through the work of the Robert Mapplethorpe Foundation. He established the foundation in 1988, to promote photography, support museums that exhibit photographic art, and to fund medical research in the fight against AIDS and HIV. Be sure to check back tomorrow for another look at a work from the Cincinnati Art Museum's permanent collection.